three basic questions: when, where, and why. And the answer is this video that you are watching right now. If you stick around till the very end of this video, you'll have a complete calendar at hand to plan a trip to any part of this incredible country called India. So, let's go.
This is Kundan from countingkilometers.com. We create travel stories about everything from mountains to oceans, from trekking and hiking to motorcycle riding and everything in between. So if this is something that interests you, please consider subscribing to our channel and following us on all our social handles.
First of all, let me tell you, this is going to be a long video because we are going to talk through all 36 states and union territories of India through the 12 months of calendar year. So one thing that I want you to do besides watching this video right now is to find out the option right here somewhere to save this video for watching later, so that you can come back anytime, and whenever you need any part of this video, you can just come back and refer to that particular part of the video, because I'm going to give you the timestamps like for each and every month down there in the description. So you can anytime come and refer to that particular part. You don't need to watch entire video again. One more thing before we begin. This video is totally based on my 15 years experience of traveling all throughout the India. I won't say all throughout because I have not been to Northeast and some parts of like MP and all. But wherever I've traveled last 15 years, that experience plus a lot of research work that I've done on like the cultural parameters, the administrative regulations and all those things. Like for the last 1 week, I've been doing all this research to make this video and the article as well. So it's totally based on that. I'll tell you for each and every month, which is the best state to visit in that particular month, like which are the best states. There won't be one, there is a list for each and every month. So I'll tell you which are the ideal places to visit in each and every month. Plus I'll tell you the second best places, like alternatives. If you have been already to some of these places which are ideal, then I'll give you the alternatives where you can now go. So you'll have best places and second best places also. And once you are done watching this entire video, find the link in the description box for the article related to this video, which is on our website. From there, you can download all these lists, all these charts for each and every month and the entire year calendar for India trip. Everything is there for the downloads. So don't forget to hit that link and check the article after this video. If you are anywhere outside India and you are watching this video for a short and sweet answer for this question, then the answer is November. Yes. November is the sweet spot. The sweet spot to visit each and every part, or I can say any part of this country. Of course, there will be some climate based restrictions on some places like Kashmir and Ladakh and Arunachal Pradesh, like which are in the Himalayan extremes. But still, you can fly in there and explore almost all the places in that particular part also. And apart from those places, you just open the map, put your finger and you'll be able to drive in there. So for planning a trip to India from anywhere outside, November is the time. Now, if you think India can be covered in 1 month or less than that, then my answer would be no. Of course, there are some websites or maybe some package tour operators which will say yes to this, but I'll say no, because it's the seventh largest country in the world, man. In 1 month, you can barely trace all four corners of India, let alone exploring entire country. So my suggestion to you is you start your trip in early November. Start with the north, then go to northeast, come to west, explore the central part of the India, and then move down south and end your trip somewhere in the late December. That is how you can cover entire country, and that will be all in the best season to explore each and every place. And don't forget to thank me later. By the way, there's more on this later in this video, so stick around, don't go away. Indians can visit India anytime, any number of times, right? Well, I know that was a joke. Just like me, I know many of you are not able to plan a whole India trip at one shot. But hang on, that's why we have this entire video from here onwards. Now, from here onwards, we'll be talking about each and every state of India through each and every month of the year. So whenever you want to plan a trip, all you have to do is find out your business or job calendar, whatever, wherever you are working, find out your free time. Mark your month when you want to set out on a trip, and the rest is here in this video. Okay, so January and February are some of those pleasant months to travel in India. The days are smaller, the temperature everywhere is somewhat cozy, Himalayas are receiving ample snowfall, and all the coastline of India is breezy and pleasant. All in all, this is one of those peak tourism seasons in many parts of India. As I said, it's a high time for traveling, and it shows. Anyways, I have this black and white print over here, so I'll show you on screen only. See, this list has 24 states in green and 10 more states in yellow. So it means only two states are missing from the list. That is Ladakh and Arunachal Pradesh. Now I know Ladakh is a union territory, but I'm going to refer to everything as a state, no matter if it's a union territory or a state, because every time I cannot remember that. Sorry. Well, anyways, for Ladakh and Arunachal Pradesh, both these states are like extreme Himalayan states. Most of the places are covered in snow, some places are inaccessible totally, some places are very risky to reach. So, all in all, those two places are understandably not in the list. But besides those two, all 34 states are here in the list. There are some other states also where there is snowfall in January, but they have some other places of interest outside of snow line, or despite of snowfall, those places are still accessible. So those places are there in the list. Okay, so this is how we are going to read the charts for each and every month now. The places in green means obviously those are the ideal states to be in that particular month. And the places in yellow means that some of the places or some of the attractions will be unavailable, but still you can go in there, and the other places which are accessible, you can go and enjoy, and you won't feel like you wasted your time in that state. For the states in green list, I won't be talking much about that. I'll tell you why I'm doing this later in this video, but for now I'll only read the list and then we'll go ahead to talk more about the list in yellow. So here's the ideal places to visit in January first, in alphabetical order. First is Andaman and Nicobar Islands, Andhra Pradesh, Bihar, Chandigarh, Chhattisgarh, Dadra and Nagar Haveli, and Daman and Diu. These two union territories were clubbed on 26th of January 2020. So there is only one union territory now. Then there's Goa, there's NCT of Delhi, Gujarat, Haryana, Karnataka, Kerala, Lakshadweep, Maharashtra, Manipur, Mizoram, Nagaland, Odisha, Puducherry, Punjab, Rajasthan, Tamil Nadu, Tripura, and West Bengal. It's a long list. I am not asking you to take a pen and paper and note it down. Just head over to our article after this video. The link is in the description. You can go and download these exact charts from there. So for now, just concentrate on the video. Well, that is the list of ideal states to be in January. So these are the best places to be. Now about the alternatives. We'll talk about the yellow list now. Now for this list, I'm going to tell you the names also, and I'm going to tell you some plus or minus points also, like some negative points why it is not in the green list, some positive points that despite of being not ideal, why is it still there in the list, why you should still consider that state. So here we go for January. First of all, there are a few states from Northeast, like there is Assam, there's Meghalaya, Sikkim, then there's Uttarakhand, Uttar Pradesh. These all states are like they are a bit too cold for comfort zone. So in January you can go there, but it will be a bit too cold. So the entire list is Assam, Himachal Pradesh, Jammu Kashmir, Jharkhand, Madhya Pradesh, Meghalaya, Sikkim, Telangana, Uttar Pradesh, and Uttarakhand. So these are the places which are second best, you can say, for visiting in January. And the plus points, if I want to tell you, so Himachal Pradesh, first of all, it will be the perfect season to go in for snow sports and chasing the snow if you're for that. Like you want to experience snowfall or you want to experience snow skiing, then Himachal Pradesh is the place and January is the month. Same with Jammu Kashmir, you can go to Sonmarg, you can go to Gulmarg, and snow sports are like full blooming over there. So January is the time to go. Uttarakhand, you can enjoy river rafting, you can enjoy bungee jumping and all that which happens in Rishikesh and Haridwar, but it is still in the yellow list because most of the pilgrim places like Kedarnath, Badrinath, then Gangotri, Yamnotri, all those places will be closed off due to winters. So that is the reason it is not in the ideal list, not in the green part. So that's it about January. Let's head on to Feb. I'll be talking about each and every month in similar fashion. So if you already have a month in mind, if you are already looking this video with that intention, then you can go directly to that particular month by checking the timestamps in the description. Also, you can download all these charts for each and every month from our article, as I said. So don't forget to check that link also. Now let's talk about February. Generally, by the end of Feb, temperature starts rising, especially in the southern states of India. And in the northern part, snowfall generally stops by the end of February. So you'll find a more number of places in yellow list than green compared to January. January, we had 24 places in the list of green. Now in February, you'll have more places in yellow. Some places will demote from green to yellow, while some, like Ladakh, for example, Ladakh will promote itself from red to yellow. The reason is coming. Okay, so the list of ideal places to visit in February. Again, Andaman Nicobar Islands, Andhra Pradesh, Assam, Bihar, Chandigarh, Dadra Nagar Haveli, Daman Diu, National Capital Territory of Delhi, Goa, Gujarat, Haryana, Karnataka, Kerala, Lakshadweep, Maharashtra, Manipur, Mizoram, Nagaland, Punjab, Rajasthan, Tamil Nadu, Tripura and West Bengal. So many of the states are common from January to February. Some have demoted to yellow. I'll check out which one are those. One of those is Chhattisgarh, Himachal Pradesh. I think Himachal Pradesh was in yellow only. Anyways, the list of yellow is Chhattisgarh, Himachal Pradesh, Jammu Kashmir, Jharkhand, Ladakh. As I said, it comes up from red to yellow. The reason being, it is perfect for experiencing snow landscapes. Like in January, the snowfall is so intense that many of the times it happens that the flights are cancelled, or even if you land in Leh, you are not able to pass Khardungla or Changla and visit Pangong or Nubra Valley. So it happens sometimes that your trip is totally ruined. Now for the eastern states like Odisha, Tamil Nadu, Puducherry and all that, the reason those states are in yellow list is because of the returning showers. In the month of February, generally these eastern coastal area that receives returning monsoon showers. So it can cause a spoil sport or discomfort. Maybe you're not prepared for rains in that particular trip and a sudden rain can totally like spoil your trip. So that's why those states are in the list of yellow. So the list, as I said, where was I? Ladakh, yeah. Then Ladakh, there is Madhya Pradesh, Meghalaya, Odisha, Puducherry, Sikkim, Telangana, Uttar Pradesh and Uttarakhand. Well, for northeast states like Meghalaya and Sikkim, those are still too cold for comfortably exploring. Then for the states in eastern, as I said, returning monsoon showers. And for the states in central India like Madhya Pradesh and Chhattisgarh, those are in the yellow list because by February, all the forests start getting dry and all the waterfalls are like totally dried out, streams are dried out. So that is the beauty of Madhya Pradesh and Chhattisgarh. You have to visit there for forests, for waterfalls, for streams, for natural beauty. And somehow these states start looking more like drought prone or something like that. So that's why those are not in the ideal places list here in February. We're just about entering the summer months and I'm all sweating already. Well, that's not because of the summer months. Of course, it is because of the summer months, but here in Karjat, that's the problem with shooting indoors. You have to switch off the fan because it interferes with the mic and it sweats like anything. Well, moving on to March. Let's go. Let me take the next page. I have the entire script today. March, April, May and almost half of June. This is that part of the year when almost half, not even half, almost the entire country is unbearably hot. So quite obviously these are the least preferred months for traveling in India. But still there are some places, like especially in the foothills of Himalaya, where the peak tourism season is beginning. Because the rest of the country is getting hot, people tend to visit the Himalayan foothills. So there are still some places which you can visit in summer and thoroughly enjoy. So let's check out these places to visit in March, April, May and June. Okay, we still have a long list for March, but most of the list is yellow. The only states in green are Assam, Dadra Nagar Haveli, Daman and Diu, Himachal Pradesh, as I said, Himalayan foothills, it's the peak season. Madhya Pradesh, Meghalaya, again in Himalayan foothills. Uttar Pradesh and Uttarakhand, once again Himalayan foothills. Madhya Pradesh is in the green list, especially because of its tiger reserves. All the national parks like Kanakisli and Bandhavgarh, summer months are the best for sighting of tigers. That's why it is in the green list. Uttar Pradesh is in the green list, especially for the cultural vivid colors like the Holi celebration. Vrindavan is a place in Uttar Pradesh where you have to visit for Holi. The Holi celebration in Vrindavan is world famous. You cannot just miss that. So that's the reason these states are in green. Now a long list of yellow. The negative part about yellow list is quite obvious. Those places are starting to get hot beyond comfort zone. That's why those places are not in the ideal places list. But there are some positives for which you should still visit those places. We'll look at those positives first. The list is like Andaman. Now Andaman Nicobar drops down from green to yellow. It starts getting hot, obviously. Andhra Pradesh, Arunachal Pradesh, Chandigarh, Chhattisgarh, NCT of Delhi, Goa, Gujarat, Haryana, Jammu Kashmir, Karnataka, Kerala, Ladakh, Lakshadweep, Maharashtra, Manipur, Mizoram, Nagaland, Odisha, Puducherry, Punjab, Rajasthan, Sikkim, Tamil Nadu, Tripura and West Bengal. So as you can see, most of the places, entire southern part of India is now in yellow because it's getting hot. Some places from up north are also in yellow. The reason is this. For Jammu and Kashmir, snowfall has stopped. So if you are in for snowfall, you won't get snowfall. No snow, no snow sports. So that is another reason why it is dropping down from green to yellow. Now getting to the plus points. You can enjoy Goa, like for beachside vacations. It is still good time to visit Goa. Now for Gujarat, again it is good time for sighting of lions, Sasangir National Park. It is the best time, March, April and May, to sight the Asiatic lions. Then Karnataka, Maharashtra, again these both states are good for sighting of wildlife in dense forests. Like in Maharashtra it is Tadoba Andhari Tiger Reserve, then in Karnataka you have Nagarhole Tiger Reserve and many more. So towards the summer, most of the hot-blooded animals like start to gather around the water reservoirs. So it is easy to sight them compared to winter months. And that's the reason these states are there in the list despite of being hot. So that's about March. Let's head on to April now. April is like the end of tourism season in India. Except for some dense forest areas and a few hill stations in southern part like Kodaikanal, like Mahabaleshwar and all those things. Apart from that, almost entire country is too hot to travel. So the list is again getting smaller because there are less number of states which are good for visiting in April. And in the month of May and June, the list will be even smaller. We'll go to it later. Let's talk about April first. Here you go. The list of greens first. Arunachal Pradesh is now a good place to visit because till February or March, it is very cold. In April and May, it is good to visit. So Arunachal Pradesh is there. Himachal Pradesh jumps from yellow to green. March, in March, it was in yellow. In April, it is again in green because of honeymoon season. The romantic getaways are like in peak season in Himachal in the month of April and May. So Himachal is there. Madhya Pradesh is there again for wildlife sighting. Meghalaya, Sikkim, Uttarakhand. All these three places are in Himalayan foothills. So when the entire country is getting hot, these places are getting pleasant to visit. Quite obvious. Then the list of yellow. Andaman Nicobar, Assam, Chandigarh, Dadra Nagar Haveli, Gujarat, Haryana, Jammu Kashmir, Kerala, Ladakh, Maharashtra and Uttar Pradesh. Most of the places are too hot and that's the reason they are in the yellow list. Ladakh is there in the yellow list because you can still visit all the parts of Ladakh, but you cannot drive into Ladakh. You have to fly in. That's the only reason it is in the yellow list. Otherwise, it would have been in the green. Jammu Kashmir, again, as I said, it is good for romantic getaways, but there is nothing else to do. You cannot drive to Ladakh from there. So all you can do is visit places like Gulmarg, Sonmarg and Srinagar, which are better seen in winters, like when they are snow clad. So if you're just going there to visit Kashmir, then this is not the right time. And that's why it is in the yellow list. So that's it about April. Let's head on to May. Welcome to the month of May. It is May right now. I'm shooting this on 7th of May 2020. Outside there's lockdown, so it is totally impossible to travel. But inside it is impossible to vlog. See, I'm sweating like anything. So visibly it is too hot and it is the least preferred season for traveling in India. So there's a small list, let's check it out. Here you go, Himachal Pradesh, as I said, still there in the green list. Meghalaya is there, Sikkim is there. Only three states in the green list because they are still pleasantly cold, not too hot. Rest, everything is either hot or too hot. Too hot goes in the red, and which is hot, but still there is something to visit, are there in the, what you call, the yellow list. Andaman Nicobar Islands, Haryana, Jammu Kashmir, Ladakh, Madhya Pradesh, Uttarakhand. Uttarakhand is good for pilgrim tours in May, because by the month of May, all those places like Gangotri, Yamunotri, Badrinath, Kedarnath are accessible. So that is the reason it is still there in the list, because you can go there for pilgrimage tours. Ladakh is there in the list because you can travel all through Ladakh, and they're not there in the green list because you cannot drive into Ladakh. I am a bit biased about it. Unless you are driving into Ladakh, I cannot get it in green. Sorry. Well, Jammu Kashmir, as I said, if you are just visiting Kashmir, then it is better visited in winters, not in the summers. Is this even a list? Out of 36 states and union territories in India, there are only 4 in the list. 32 places are not suitable for visiting in the month of June. The reason? June is the most awkward time of the year to travel. Like, it is too hot in most of the places. Monsoon is just around the corner, and especially entire western coastline like Kerala, Goa, Karnataka, Maharashtra, all these places become too unpredictable. Anytime the monsoon can start and your travel plan is like totally lapsed. So it is totally an awkward time to visit. And most importantly, most of the places in India are suffering from water shortage in this period. Let's face it, I'm not talking negative about India, but I don't want to give you false picture and then ruin your experience later when you plan according to that. So let's face it, in the month of May and June, there will be water scarcity in most of the states in India. So that is a difficulty in planning any tour in this particular period. Well, still, we are going to talk about June, and the reason is Himalayas once again. In the month of June, you get a clear passage to travel anywhere in Himalayas. The roads to Ladakh, Jammu Kashmir, Sikkim, Arunachal, everywhere the roads are open, you can drive into those places. And if you're asking about one thing to do in the month of June, it's got to be a road trip to Himalayas. Okay, so it's a short list. Himachal Pradesh, Jammu Kashmir and Ladakh in the green. As I said, Ladakh is in the green because you can drive into Ladakh now. Jammu Kashmir is in the green because you can drive into Ladakh now. I'm sorry, everything comes to Ladakh now. Because especially you can drive into Kashmir, you can visit all the places in Jammu and Kashmir and then come club it with Ladakh. Let me tell you, by the end of June, especially in the mid-July somewhere, the Amarnath pilgrimage starts. And that makes Jammu Kashmir a risky place to visit in the month of June and July. Unfortunately, it is true. I'm sorry, but it happens. Every year it happens. June and July are the riskiest months to visit Kashmir. But still, if you want to visit Ladakh, you can drive through Kashmir. And Jammu Kashmir will be in the green list for that particular reason. Now, the only place here in the list of yellow is Meghalaya. And it is there because the temperatures are not too hot. But it is there in yellow and not in green because monsoons don't reach Meghalaya in June. Definitely not, because it is in far northeast, so the monsoon start late over there and it has gone through entire summer season, so understandably the waterfalls and streams are weak or maybe non-existent, and that's the reason it is in the yellow list, not the most preferred time to visit Meghalaya. That's it about June, and now we're going into monsoons. थोड़ा ज्यादा हो गया ना. वेल, इट्स टाइम टू चेंज द मूड, चेंज द क्लोथ्स एंड चेंज एवरीथिंग, बिकॉज बाय द एंड ऑफ जून द मॉनसून सेट्स इन, एंड फॉर द मंथ ऑफ जुलाई, ऑगस्ट एंड सेप्टेंबर, दिस थ्री मंथ्स इट रेन्स लाइक कैट्स एंड डॉग्स. एंटायर कंट्री इज लाइक हैविंग अ फ्रेश शॉवर. इट्स लाइक रिफ्रेशिंग, बट फ्रॉम द ट्रैवलिंग पर्सपेक्टिव दीज मंथ्स आर क्वाइट ट्रिकी. देर आर अ लॉट ऑफ अनसर्टेनिटीज एंड लॉट ऑफ रिस्क इन्वॉल्व due to rains, due to landslides and all those things at various places. Many of the people would even recommend you to avoid traveling in these months, but then it means that you are missing out on a big chunk of India's beauty, which is only there in the month of monsoons. So I won't say don't travel in monsoons. I still have some places for you to put your pins on. These are some of those places where you'll get some jaw-dropping scenes, where you'll get some unusual experiences, and you'll just love them. I can't explain much. And most importantly, monsoons means it is gateway to heavens. Again, I'm coming to Ladakh. Not just Ladakh, Uttarakhand, Sikkim, all these places in Himalayas, they are wide open with all the roads connected. So it's the peak season for traveling to Himalayas, and it's also a good season to travel in Sahyadris and places down south where it is raining very heavily, but still you have some places to visit. Let's go for that. July is again a short list, just five names in there. Jammu Kashmir and Ladakh are at their best, as I just said, and Himachal Pradesh is also there now in yellow because by this time heavy monsoon sets in places, many places of Himachal Pradesh. So landslide and all those things can play a spoil sport. So that's the reason it is in yellow, not in green. But the most important thing I want to draw your attention to is the re-entry of Karnataka and Maharashtra. These are the two states where you'll get n number of waterfalls in all shapes and sizes, like all the forest trails, treks, and it's a different kind of beauty. It's another heaven on earth. If Himalaya is heaven on earth, Maharashtra and Karnataka in monsoon is another heaven on earth. You have to visit Maharashtra or Karnataka in July, August, or September. So in July, Maharashtra and Karnataka are in yellow along with Himachal. Let's head on to August now. As you can expect, as we go deep into the monsoons, like in August and September, the list goes on increasing, and especially more places from the central part of India come into picture again. See, if you see the list for August, I'll read the yellow list first because that is where most interesting part is. See, Goa is back in the list, Jharkhand is back in the list, Karnataka and Maharashtra is still there, Madhya Pradesh is back in the list, and these all states make their entry just for their forests and waterfalls. So you can imagine, if you want to visit lush green forests, waterfalls, streams, rivers, and you want to enjoy rains, this is the time, these are the places. Himachal Pradesh is still there in yellow, Jammu Kashmir and Ladakh still in green. As I said, this is the best time to visit those two states. Now, September is the month that gives us first hint of that pleasant season of traveling to come. By mid of September, the monsoons are generally over. The rivers are in full flow, all the waterfalls and all the streams are in full flow. There is no snowfall, but still you can visit Himalayan places, Himalayan states. Then the temperatures are pretty pleasant. And what more can I say? I can go on talking about September. It is one of the most favorite times of the year for me. Okay, so as expected, the list goes on increasing once again. There are three states in green list for September: Himachal Pradesh, Maharashtra, and Telangana. Maharashtra is there because of waterfalls, forests, and all the treks and all the beauty that Maharashtra has to offer. Then Telangana is there for the heritage monuments and lakes, especially lakes. Lakes are best visited in September. The lakes, the clouds drama, and the sky color. These three things together in the month of September, it's like blessing. You have to see it to believe it. So these are the three states in green. Now a big list for yellow: Andhra Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, NCT of Delhi, Goa, Gujarat, Jammu Kashmir, Jharkhand, Karnataka, Kerala, Ladakh, Madhya Pradesh, and Uttarakhand. Most of these places are there for their forests, waterfalls, and streams and rivers. Then Jammu Kashmir and Ladakh are down from green to yellow because the season is about to end by the end of September. Anytime the snowfall can start and the roads to Ladakh can block. So that's the reason it is towards the end of that season. That's the reason they are in yellow, not in green. So that's about September, and that's it about the monsoon season. I should remind you, all these month-wise charts are available for download in the article which is on our website. The link is down in the description. And now we are heading towards the winter season. As I said, the best season to travel in India. So stay tuned. Okay, so we are now heading towards the business end of this discussion, the winter season. I know that there's something called October heat, But in India, here we have a permanent blessing called Himalaya. Whenever we feel it is too hot, there is one or the other place in Himalaya which is good to visit. So let's go, let's check out the last three and the most ideal 3 months of tourism in India, the October, November, and December. And on the other side of that, I'll tell you how you can actually pick and choose from this list of places to visit in each and every month and how you can take your planning of India trip further. So don't go anywhere. The list of places for October is bigger than all those monsoon months for one simple reason. All those places which were closed for monsoon are now back in operation, and a major share of that goes to the coastal towns, the coastal states like the Konkan, the eastern coast. All these places, coastal towns, are back into operation, back into business with all their water sports, then the culinary specialties and culture, and like whichever places in the coastal area you cannot visit in monsoon, they are now open. So that's the reason it is a big list. Besides that, most of the places in Himalayas are still accessible. Though you cannot reach to Ladakh by road, I am coming back to Ladakh. Still, you can visit Ladakh, you can visit Kashmir, all those places are open to fly in and explore. So that's the reason this is a big list. The list in green is comparatively smaller. Only five states there: Arunachal Pradesh, Assam, Sikkim, Telangana, and Uttarakhand. But the list of yellow is huge. There's Andaman and Nicobar, Andhra Pradesh, Chandigarh, Chhattisgarh, Dadra Nagar Haveli, NCT of Delhi, Himachal, Jammu Kashmir, Jharkhand, Karnataka, Kerala, Ladakh, Lakshadweep, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Odisha, Puducherry, Punjab, Tamil Nadu, Uttar Pradesh, and West Bengal once again. As you can see, all these places which were closed for monsoon, all these coastal states are now back in the list. So it's clearly monsoons are over, winters are about to begin, and that's the reason the list is big. There are a lot of places you can visit in October. So don't get under the word October heat. You have a lot of places to visit. As I said, November is the sweet spot to visit any part of India. And look at the list. All 36 states and union territories are there. No exclusion. You know what that means? It means that there is no place in India where you should not be in November. So it's a big list of 23 states and union territories in the green and another 13 in yellow. I'll only explain the yellow part. Green part you can watch on the screen and you can download the chart from the article, as I already said. Besides that, if you remember, I said you should start the trip in November and end in December. More on that just after this chart. So first of all, there are some Himalayan states like Arunachal Pradesh is there, then Himachal Pradesh is there, Ladakh is there. These places are there because these places are still good to visit, but snowfall can start anytime. And if snowfall starts, then you are stuck. That's a bit of risk of being there in the month of November. That's the reason they're in the yellow list, not in the green. Besides that, places like Maharashtra and Gujarat are there because especially the wildlife sightings. Like for Gujarat, there's Sachin Gir National Park, for Maharashtra, the Taduba Andhari Tiger Reserve. These forests are too dense. So as I explained earlier also, the wildlife sighting is quite difficult in this season. So if you're looking from that perspective, this is not the ideal time. But still, the waterfalls and treks and all those things are there. Winter has started, so all the hill stations are beautiful. And in that perspective, most of these places are great to be there. So the list for November for yellow part, like the second best alternatives, is Arunachal Pradesh, Chandigarh, Gujarat, Haryana, Himachal Pradesh, Ladakh, Maharashtra, Manipur, Meghalaya, Mizoram, so almost entire northeast, except for Arunachal. Arunachal is also there, but Arunachal again, snowfall, chances of snowfall are more in Arunachal. So where was I? Yeah, Manipur, Meghalaya, Mizoram, Nagaland, Punjab, and Tripura. So almost entire northeast is good to visit in November, but not ideal. So there you go, November. Keep in mind, if you want to plan your first trip, November is like, just close your eyes and head off to anywhere. Everything is good. Okay, so if you have noticed carefully, the majority of states in the yellow list of November were from north and northeast. Almost entire northeast was there. Ladakh and Himachal Pradesh and all those places from north were there. That is because it is onset of winters, and by December, those places become even more chilled. So, in fact, some of the places like Ladakh, Sikkim, and Arunachal Pradesh are not at all in the list of December. They are down to the red because by December snowfall starts over there and most of the places become inaccessible and risky to reach, as I said earlier. So Ladakh, Sikkim and Arunachal are out of the list. But if you notice carefully, the list of ideal places, the green list, is even bigger for December. From 23 in November, it has grown to 28 in December, which means that even more parts of India are ideal for visiting in December. That is the reason I had said start in November, cover the north and northeast, and then travel down south because all the southern parts of India are ideal to visit in December. So now you get the entire story. We'll talk about a small list of only five states which are there in yellow, which are not the best. One is Assam, of course, because it is a bit too cold in December. Gujarat is there again, as I said. It is early for visiting the salt flats also, Run of Kutch, which is ideally open in January, so December is too early. And again for wildlife sighting also December is too early. Meghalaya, Telangana and Uttarakhand. Uttarakhand again by the mid of December, all these places, Gangotri, Yamunotri, Kedarnath, Badrinath, all those places are snowbound, so those are out of bounds, not reachable. So as you saw, November and December are the most ideal months to visit any place in India. And now we'll go ahead and talk about how you can actually plan your trip ahead from here. So now you have a complete list of when and where and why to be in India. But there's one more question that I didn't mention earlier, and that is how. How to plan this trip. As you all saw in this entire video, I've not talked about individual places or points of interest in a particular state unless it was really necessary to explain. That is majorly because I didn't want to make it a 3 hours movie to watch. But then, now I'm going to tell you in short about how you can actually take it ahead from here and plan your own itinerary for your trip to any place in India. I have a list of pointers here, so it's easier for me to explain. So number one, mark your vacations on the calendar and check this particular video once again and find out the places which are ideal for that particular month, which is quite obvious you'll do that. Now number two, dive deep into our channel, into our website, find out different articles, different blogs about different places, find out through some other channels, some other resources also, and make a complete list of ideal places to visit in that particular state. Once you've frozen the name of the state, okay, this is November, I want to visit this state. Then search entire YouTube and the websites, blogs, travel blogs for that particular state and make a list of places of interest in that particular state. Then number three is if you're looking at a smaller state, you can try to club two or more states in a single trip. That way you can cover more parts of India in a lesser amount of time. Okay, this is very important. Number four, if you understand Hindi, I'll strongly recommend you to watch this particular video which I've linked over here, because this video is exactly what you'll need to take your planning ahead from this point. You have shortlisted the state to visit and you want to plan in detail about your itinerary, and this video is exactly that. So go ahead and watch this video. Number five, once you're done planning or while you're planning, if you need any kind of help, you can comment down below or you can DM us on Facebook or Instagram. I'll be there to help you. But for that, you need to be following us on Facebook and Instagram. I'm assuming you are. If not, here are the handles. Go ahead and follow. Number six, as I've said a number of times in this video, there's an article discussing about this particular topic on our website. The link is down in the description. Go ahead and check that article. You can download all these monthly charts and a complete year calendar for India trip from that article. It's there. It's in high resolution. You can download, zoom in, and check whatever you want. So go ahead and check that article also. Number seven. Now, if you're watching this video till this point, that means you have liked this video. So please hit the like button. Don't leave without liking this video, please. And number eight, if you feel this information was useful, please share it with others. Sharing is the only way of caring. There are two more. Wait, don't go. Number nine. This is quite obvious. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, go ahead and subscribe. Now it's the high time to subscribe. And number 10 is the most important. Stay tuned, stay connected, and stay happy. Keep counting kilometers.